Good afternoon and welcome to the balcony and the magnificent Fisk organ here at First Presbyterian Church in Evansville. It's Maundy Thursday and normally we would be preparing for a rather busy evening. Children would be coming in for their afternoon programs and the choir would be preparing for the Maundy service this evening. But in lieu of that, there will be a live stream service at 7 p.m. And here at noon, as we've been doing since the lockdown began, I'm going to present about half an hour of music. Today, it's all going to be based on the same theme. For those of you familiar with the Presbyterian hymnal, it's number 98, O Sacred Head Now Wounded. It appears in many, many, many denominational hymnals and is often known by its German name, Herzlich tut mich verlangen. So all of the music, I'm going to start with some pieces, actually a piece by Bach, and then some of his contemporaries just before and just after, and then we'll migrate into some slightly more modern material. So I'll start by just playing the melody so that we all know what it is, and so I will start with an not as ornamented as some of Bach's chorales, but an ornamented chorale setting of the melody. Thank you. The next setting is by the famed French organist of the 20th century, Marcel Dupré, and it's from his setting of 79 chorale prelude settings, which he considered a kind of warm-up for learning the music of Bach. What's interesting and different about this particular piece, in amongst all of those that I'm playing today, is that the melody is played twice. Two counts after the melody begins, it begins in a following voice, also in the oboe up on the top manual, but played a fourth lower. It's quite cleverly put together, and I'm sure you'll be able to pick out the melody and the melody a second time, two beats later. And now we move back in time and down a step into A minor, into the printed key, which we would sing this hymn in if we were here today singing in church in A minor. Many settings in this particular key. We're going to hear first a piece by Kernberger, which is a little bit more jolly, a bit more arpeggiated in the left hand. A rather unusual setting by Telemann, which has the melody, or the cantus firmus, as we music nerds call it, actually in a very low voice in the left hand, and today we're going to hear that on our bass clarinet. And then a setting by Buxtehude, who was highly revered by Bach, and whom Bach went to visit. He took a long walk, and I think it's something like 120, maybe more miles, and he walked to hear Buxtehude when Bach was a young man. He said he'd be gone for 2 months, and he started to get letters from his employer after, I don't know, four or five, saying, you need to get back home. But Bach was learning so much from Buxtehude that he extended his stay quite considerably before heading back to Eisenach. So settings by Kernberger, Telemann, and Buxtehude. Thank you. And now, we skip ahead to the 19th century and the composer Johannes Brahms. Brahms wrote quite a bit of organ music towards the beginning of his career, and including some preludes and fugues and various other pieces. And then right at the end of his life, actually published posthumously, his opus 122, a setting of 11 chorale preludes, two of which are based on the melody that we are working with today. All of them have a great sense of pathos, as a sort of sense of retrospective of the composer laying on his deathbed and writing his very last musical utterances, and to be published after he has died. The first one is sort of grander and quite chromatic, and I'll use all of the foundation stops on the instrument. And then the second one is much more lilting and flowing, and is a much more intimate setting. Thank you. And finally, a modern setting by the living composer Pamela Decker. Pamela is from Arizona and is a widely published, very highly respected American composer who composes in all genres, but is particularly loved amongst organists because of her vast output for the instrument. She plays, and I had the pleasure of meeting her in 2000 in Seattle. I believe she was having a piece premiered, and those of us in the National Improvising Competition were given themes to compose for the various rounds, all of which were written by Pamela Decker. It may not be immediately apparent, but almost every single note of what is written, again, it's very chromatic and moves around a lot, but all of the material is based on the opening gestures, the opening phrases of our hymn tune, chorale melody today. So, Herzlich tut mit Verlangen by Pamela Decker.